Around the middle of the Cold War, Dassault engineers finalized their unique approach towards aircraft development. After the Ouragan, a fighter bomber that was pretty typical for its time, France transitioned to delta-wing designs. Supersonic flight required completely new ideas and approaches. Of course, Dassault wasn't the only company to use delta wings. There are plenty of other famous aircraft with this design, but the French made tailless delta-wing planes their hallmark, and few would doubt that their creations were among the most impressive ones. In the early 1970s, when the Vietnam experience was thoroughly analyzed, American engineers created three fighters of a brand new generation, the F-14, the F-15, and the F-16. McDonnell Douglas created the Eagle as a fighter that could achieve uncontested superiority in air combat. It was a fusion of two extremely powerful engines, amazing aerodynamics, the latest avionics, and cutting-edge missiles. Dassault's reaction to the F-15 was the Mirage 4000. They reused some of the solutions implemented in previous projects. On the outside, the new Mirage was similar to its predecessors with its delta wing and hull shape, with a less obvious change in the form of canards. The main differences between the Mirage 4000 and previous planes were its large size and a two-engine design. Almost all planes made by Dassault before that were close-range light fighters, while the 4000 was designed to reinforce the heavy class and become an effective long-range interceptor. Two engines brought extra reliability and thrust, while the larger size meant it had enough space for arms and fuel. Unlike the F-15, the Mirage 4000 wasn't exclusively focused on air combat. Thanks to the Atlas targeting pod, it could deliver precision strikes with guided bombs, turning the plane into a long-range, multi-role aircraft. The French engineers employed some highly unusual solutions to make this vehicle as versatile and effective as possible. For instance, its hull was designed with composite materials to reduce mass. However, the expensive and sophisticated project failed to attract enough attention from the French defense or foreign buyers. The circumstances were unfavorable, so after lengthy trials and demos, the new aircraft had to be sent to the museum. As it often happens, the development effort wasn't wasted. The groundwork was later used for the Rafale multi-role fighter. However, that plane wasn't part of the Mirage family anymore. Model 4000 remained a dead end in the history of the Mirage.